Hi, my name is Sharon Bridgeforth, and I'm the creator of the That Black Mermaid Man Lady Project. You can go to blackmermaidmanlady.com to get more information and to find out more about these oracle cards that are part of the project. Today I'm going to do a 3-card reading. This is a reading for the week using the That Black Mermaid Man Lady Oracle deck. We will be selling this deck very soon. If you sign up to our mailing list on thatblackmermaidmanlady.com, you'll be the first to know. And you will also automatically be entered into a reading to receive a free 5-card reading from me. We're going to do drawings on a weekly basis for a limited time. But for today, let's get our weekly reading started. So I'm going to pull 3 cards. The oracles are actually characters from the That Black Mermaid Man Lady show, and the text that they say are actually from the script. I think it's important to know that this is a ocean deck, so it tends to speak to what's under the surface, and it is an ancestor deck. So most of the oracles are actually ancestors, and they sit at the bottom of the ocean, which to me also connects with the sky and the air. They just want love for us. They just want health. They just want abundance. They just want us to carry forward the best life possible for ourselves and for those to come and those that have been. So for this week, here we go. All right, the first card is Miss Kitty. And Miss Kitty speaks of joy. And I think the thing to know about Miss Kitty is she is absolutely herself. And so what she's saying on the back of the card, you won't be able to read it there, but on the back, what she's saying is, be yourself. And Miss Kitty, with the support of her community and her elders, came into her power fully as she made the divine and also scary and hard choice to fully be herself. So Miss Kitty is saying that follow your joy, basically, and that joy is through the action of being yourself. All right, that's the first part of the week. Middle of the week is Dreamer. And this represents you. This represents whoever the deck is speaking to, or whoever is pulling the cards. And it says your soul. So the dreamer is being held by the ancestors and by the ocean, and is releasing to their soul's deepest intentions, greatest desires, and infinite love's highest will. And it says deep emotions on the back. That black mermaid man lady, come to me in my dreams, black like a most beautiful night sky, eyes shining like stars, skirt deep blue, dark like skin, hair got 1,000 fishes and pearls hanging all the way down past behind. That black mermaid man lady, come to me in my dreams, take my hand, pull me down, down, down to the bottom. At the very bottom of the ocean, I see things. So middle of the week is deep emotions. It's also an opportunity to go in, to go down, to be lifted, and to be in the flow of divine support. End of week, Sweetie Junior. Sweetie Junior say clarity. Sweetie Junior, on Sweetie Junior's arms, it says, get on up and fly. And that's a message within the world of this piece that Sweetie Junior got from an elder. And in the world of this piece, that particular elder represents divine opportunity. So Sweetie Junior is saying, get on up and fly, baby. And on the back, it says alignment. They be talking to the night, do what need to be did, for us, for all, taking care of whatever business need to be taken care of. look like Sweetie Jr. come back from she grand nana tasked to that. So I think joy, if we take them all together, being yourself fully, following your joy, being in your divine flow of support, of infinite love, of your soul's highest will and deepest dreams for you, and being clear puts you in alignment. So that's what they got to say today. All right, so sign up, thatblackmermaidmanlady.com, and I'll see you next week for a reading. All right, blessings.